Namaskar. My name is Indu Prakash and I'm a teacher of English grammar at the English Lyceum, New Delhi. Today we'll discuss the use of had and simple past tense. We can remove a number of had and had been from our books and newspapers if we know the rules governing these things. Sentence number one, I had given him some money in 1960. Number two, I gave him some money in 1960. I had given him some money before 1960. The rule is we use had and had been when there are three times. Number one, time of action. Number two, some intermediate time. Number three, the time of speaking or writing. If we apply this rule, we can easily find the error in these sentences. Now, in first sentence, there are only two times. 1960 and now when I am writing. So this sentence is not correct. Number two, I gave him some money in 1960. There are only two times, times of action and now. So this is correct. I had given him some money before 1960. This is the most crucial sentence in this lecture. Now there are three times. Time of giving money, some intermediate time, before 1960 is intermediate time because money was given to him before that time. So the act of giving happened before 1960. And there is time of writing or speaking now when I am giving this lecture. Time of action, some intermediate time, and time of writing or speaking. This sentence has three times and we can use had here. This sentence has two times, we can use past simple tense. This sentence has only two times and had cannot be used here. This is one curiosity of the English language. The second curiosity is, gave has two objects, him and some money. Him and some money. Him and some money. The verb here has two objects, him and some money. One is indirect object and second is the direct object. It is another curiosity of the English language that only a few verbs can take two objects. They are give, send, pay, write, bequeath. These verbs of English can take two objects. Indirect object and direct object. I wrote John two letters. I sent him my message yesterday. I paid Amit rupees 2000. He wrote me two letters. My father bequeathed me a house. This is how some verbs can take two objects. One indirect and one direct. There is one more curiosity of the English language where a verb can take two direct objects. These verbs are called in English facultative verbs. Give, send, pay, write, bequeath, take indirect object and direct object. I wrote John, two letters. John is indirect object, a letter is direct object. But a few verbs in the English language can take two direct objects. They are the verbs of calling, considering, making. We call Gandhiji a saint. So, one more curiosity of the English language. Call is a verb. Gandhiji is one direct object. A saint is second direct object. We considered Gandhiji the greatest statesman. Consider. Gandhiji made Jawaharlal Nehru our Prime Minister. Made is a verb. Jawaharlal Nehru, one direct object, our Prime Minister, second other. Now these are certain curiosities of English language which make it very interesting. For all other things, you please visit our website where you'll find our blogs for highlighting the importance of these rules in learning English as a foreign language and in making English your lifelong acquisition. Namaskar and thank you to all of you.